Houston Real Estate Radio.
Thanks for tuning in to Houston Real Estate Radio, where we bring you guests and information you can use in your next real estate transaction. If you have a real estate question, you can call in anytime. That number is 281-882-8088. And anything we talk about on air, you can find on our website at rrea.com/radio. You can also tweet us your questions using hashtag HRER. If we answer your question on air next Sunday, you may qualify for a gift card from our friends at the Lowe's in Tomball. Next is our spotlight on a local business. Chuck Blair with Affordable American Air is here in the RREA.com studio today. We're going to be talking about a couple of different things. I want to talk a little bit about heating and air conditioning, what some of the HVAC changes are in the industry, but also he has another company, the Eco Ranger, where they help out with some energy efficiency in the home. And they also specialize in ductwork cleaning, installing the radiant barriers, and of course, coming out and servicing air conditioning units and certainly helping you get those replaced and upgraded when needed. This is a veteran-owned company, which seems really fitting since this is the week of the anniversary for September 11th. And just want to welcome you to the show and really tell you that this is a very interesting subject for me because my dad owns a heating and air conditioning company. So it's interesting. I grew up submerged in all of this information, but I really know very little about the industry. It's amazing how that happened. It can be quite technical, as we were talking about before the show.
It can.
A lot of changes in the industry. Tell us a little bit about the changes that have gone on in the last couple of years.
Well, in the last couple of years, the R22 Freon is being phased out by the government, and they're starting with the 410A, and the 410A is supposed to be more environmentally friendly. And during the repairs, if you repair some of your old units, you have to be really careful that they're compatible with the, because if you go and replace half of it and want to replace the other half of it, they might not work together.
Mm-hmm.
So you need to ask your AC and heating guy which would be the best way to go.
Okay. And one of the things that I always find really confusing are these SEER ratings. Can you tell us a little bit about those, what it is, what it means?
Well, the SEER rating, SEER stands for Seasonal Energy Efficiency Ratio. And the lowest one that you can buy now is a 13 SEER, which is an entry grade level AC unit. And if you upgrade to a higher, they go all the way up to approximately 18 SEER.
Mm-hmm.
In normal home units. The higher you go, the more energy efficient your home will be, so it'll cost less to keep your home cool.
So if you're buying a new home, should you get an 18 SEER unit? I mean, is that going to mean you have the best efficiency, or does it just depend on the house?
Well, actually, the 18 SEERs are the Cadillac.
Okay.
The builders seldom put the Cadillac units in.
They're expensive.
If they do put something expensive in, it's something you can visually see.
Mm.
So most builders all put a 13 SEER in.
Okay.
And there's other comfort and energy efficiency AC units that have two-stage systems in them.
Mm-hmm.
A two-stage system is, say you have a 5-ton AC unit, and in the heat of the day, it'll be a 5-ton. And after the sun goes down and your heat load isn't as much, it'll turn into a 2 or 2.5 ton. And the blower speed is slowed down, so it'll take less energy, it'll make you more comfortable.
Mm-hmm.
It will run a little bit longer at that lower stage and dehumidify the air better.
Which we need in Houston.
And we definitely need in Houston. They're really popular in Houston.
You know, that it really sounds like they've brought a lot of new technology to the industry. I mean, that's a pretty high-speed piece of equipment to be able to, you know the difference between the seasons and the times of day and how to run efficiently.
Well, it's actually it's about time, because the AC unit has been about the same since its development in the late 1800s. Mm-hmm. So they're now slowly coming up to the 21st century, and they have some real exciting stuff.
Yeah, with that. I would think it takes a lot more to become certified to be in the HVAC industry than it did years ago.
Actually, they are a lot more complicated, but they are real simple to work on.
Yeah,
so
well, that's good.
It is. So yeah. They're, and they don't have a lot of problems with them.
Mm-hmm. That's good. Is there any particular unit type or brand that you recommend, or do you work on all different, or you, do you put in all different types of systems?
Well, a lot of people put the name of certain units on their truck, and they mm-hmm. get kickbacks from the manufacturers, mm-hmm. and the manufacturers try to rope you in to be exclusive. I'm a member of an organization that we kind of all pool our buying power together. So I actually put in what you want. I can get most any piece of equipment.
So if you want a ream or you want a train or a
well,
good
I'm a train dealer, a ream dealer, I'm an Amana dealer. So I'm plugged in really heavily with all of the equipment types.
Mm-hmm.
So it just depends on what you're after.
Okay.
And we can just custom make the unit for you and whatever works best for you.
Okay. And what about ductwork cleaning? You know, that it seems like to me in the last several years that's been a big, almost like a fad. You see lots of coupons and lots of advertisements for ductwork cleaning. Is it something that's really necessary in your opinion, and how do you know if you need it?
Well, actually, we have a special camera that goes up and looks in the ducts, because
mm-hmm.
a lot of people ask me, you know, how often should I get my ducts cleaned?
Right.
And really, it just depends. Do you live on a dirt road? How many dogs and kids do you have? You know,
mm-hmm.
I mean, do you
a
have
lot of
carpet,
variables.
Not, you know, hardwood floors type of thing?
Mm-hmm.
The industry says every 7 years.
Okay.
But I say, let us come out and do a free camera inspection, and you and I will look at the camera together and decide if they're dirty enough to clean.
So you can see from the camera if they are, like, if they have dust in them, or if there's dirt built up, or if it's discolored. What are you looking for?
Well, actually, I'm looking for mold, mildew, and heavy dust.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of it, you know, I could write my name in it.
That's
so,
not good.
You know, to do a contrast. And along with that, a lot of people call me out when they have allergies mm-hmm. or they have asthma in the family or something.
Right. Mm-hmm.
So we not only do we check the ducts out and see if they need cleaned, we also check the plenums and all the equipment that's touched to the duct work.
Mm-hmm.
But we have some air filtration options too. There's UV lights, there's UVC lights,
mm-hmm.
which is a different band of light that kills bacteria and viruses, and then there's UVC lights.
Which one do you recommend?
Well, they both do two different jobs.
Okay.
The UVC, which is really important because of the bacteria and the viruses. The UVV has a, it kills the smells.
Okay.
And,
so pet odors and...
And toxic fumes, like from glues and new carpet.
New paint.
Yeah, exactly, that kind of thing.
Mm-hmm.
And then there's other smaller ones, that the one-inch filters that we can replace that also have free flowing and won't restrict the AC unit, but catches 97%. Of everything that passes through it.
Well, let's talk about those filters for a minute. You know, you can go to the grocery store and just buy the throwaway filters, or you can have, you know, be recommended to filters that you can wash out and clean and put back in. I mean, the filters can be quite complicated, and then there's the real simplistic version. Which one is best? How do you know what to buy?
Well, it's really hard to say what's best because they're individual. It depends on how big of an air return you have.
Okay.
Most builders put undersized air returns. There's a formula that tells you how big a return that your particular house should have.
Mm-hmm.
And according to that, if you're undersized and you put in a real restrictive filter, then you're hurting the AC and heating because it can't breathe right.
Mm-hmm.
the manufacturers are even making it confusing. The filter manufacturers, because the how good a filter is goes by what they call a MERV rating. So there's a MERV rating that's a 3 or a 4 or a 5 or a 10 or
so
a 12.
Do you really need to just talk to your service company and find out what kind of filters you need? I mean, is every house, you know, different to the point that you just need to get a recommendation from whoever's servicing your units?
Well, you kind of do, but there's a little bit of a conflict there because the lower the filter grade, the better it is, basically, for your AC unit.
Okay.
The fiberglass filters that catch small children and bicycles, and that's about it, works the best for the AC unit.
Because it lets more air come through.
It lets more air come through, and you won't have a lot of complicated pressure issues.
Mm-hmm.
But anything above that is for people. So you have to talk to somebody that's really an AC guy that has your best interest of health.
Mm-hmm.
So there's a lot of different options on what you can do, but just going out and buying an allergen filter
mm-hmm.
probably wouldn't be the best for you.
That's interesting. Okay. Definitely want to talk to somebody and get some advice on your particular circumstances. All right, what about I tell you what, let's go to break, and when we come back, I want to find out what is the most important thing that people need to know about with maintaining their units. I know there are a lot of companies that do service contracts. Some people only get them maintained when they're not working. So I want to talk to you about that. We'll be right back after this commercial break.